Hello, Jeff, some middle school euphonium students again. This video is going to be the slow unison etude for region band, region 29. What I'm going to do is I'm going to play through it just like I would if I were auditioning. And then I'm going to go back, after I play through it, I'm going to go back and talk about some of the things to watch for in it. So the first thing you'll hear is me playing the etude straight all the way through. This is the slow etude. One, two, three. Seeing the music, it was a little too low for me, so I had a little trouble with that. So I'm going to move it a little bit so I can see it better. Okay, so going back to the beginning, and my trouble was at the end of it. I was having trouble seeing the notes down there at the bottom, so I think I played them right. Okay, so let's go back to the beginning of this. One of the things that you need to really pay attention to in this piece are the articulations. In other words, you have a lot of slur markings or legato markings over some of the notes, but not all of the notes. So you're going to be tonguing some notes while slurring other notes. At the very beginning, the first note obviously is tongued, but then the next two notes after that are not. But the first note in the second measure is tongued, but then you've got a string of notes there down to the G that are all slurred. Then you tongue the B flat, slur the D, and tongue the G. So it gets really complicated if we're talking about it, but here's what it sounds like. So everything wasn't. That's slurring everything. And it also wasn't. Right? You hear the difference in all three. So you have to pay attention to which notes are slurred. A good example of that, measure 5 and 6. It's ta ta. The first note in each group of four is tongued.
Mm-hmm.
realize I kind of put a little space between the last note so you could hear the tongue at the beginning of each group. You know, just try to be sure that you're doing that, that you're tonguing the first in the group, but slurring the other three notes in the group. But backing up before that, I just wanted to touch on that. So you come out of, in measure three, you have a dotted half note, and then you have a triplet. Da, triplet, da. Three notes in one beat. I'm not real sure how you all do it. If you do triplet, 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 like I did, or if you go one lolly, two lolly, if you count them that way. It doesn't really matter what sound you use, as long as you put three equal notes in a beat. Da 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 da, triplet, triplet, one lolly, two lolly, one and a, two and a. Really doesn't matter. So here's measure three, starting on the dotted half note. Okay. Now, let's since I already played measure five and six, let's go to measure seven on the second note of the measure. So we've already played the first note of measure seven. So again, listening for articulations. I tongue some notes, slur other notes. So you know what? I'll just start on measure six. So let me do measure eight again. So it's a little tricky because sometimes it feels like you should tongue notes that are not supposed to be tongued, and sometimes it feels like you should not tongue a note, but it is marked so that you should tongue. So you have to really watch in this one. Here's the end of measure 10, going to 11. So there's a few things there. You've got more triplets in measure 12. You've got triplets again. And again, you're slurring notes that maybe you wouldn't if you're not really paying attention. Also, I didn't say this, but another big part of this piece is playing the dynamics, your crescendos, your decrescendos, pianos, mezzo forte. Try to make a difference. You know, when it's forte, play loudly. When it's mezzo piano or piano, you need to be playing softer. Okay, so notice we got to measure 16. Oh, and the retard in measure 15. So notice how I slowed down there. And then measure 16 has a fermata. So you hold that out. It's up to you how long you want to hold it out. Don't hold it out forever, but, you know, don't be afraid to hold it and just rest on that note until you're ready to go on to the next one. Now, we're going to take the pickup to measure 17, but between measure 16 and 17, we have a key change. So we started out in the key of B flat, and E flat. Now we're adding a flat. We're adding A flat to the key signature. And you'll notice that there's some B naturals. Now, what we're actually doing is we're changing to what's called C minor. So it's going to have a little bit of a sadder sound in this part. You know, because the first is slower, it maybe doesn't sound super happy. But now it's going to actually be in a minor key, so that it sounds a little bit more sad. Okay, so here is pick up to measure 17. Did kind of come back and change to a happier sound, but again, you've got some B naturals in there to watch for, and your articulations, measure 19, every two notes are, you know, tongue slur, like that. And you're going to have some more of that in this next thing. Again, dynamics. Notice I didn't play it all one level. I crescendoed and decrescendoed. Okay, so here's pick up to measure 23. We're gonna have some more of that tongue, the first note, slur the second, tongue, slur, through here, and dynamics. So in that last section, something that I didn't talk about earlier that there are in this, dotted 8/16ths, D-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-da, like in measure 29, D-da-da-da-da-da-da. It's a very uneven rhythm. The first note is long, and then the second note is quick. Dee da dee da dee da dee da da. So you've got some other 16th dotted 8/16ths up towards the beginning that I didn't think about. I forgot to mention those. So again, you've got poco retard, a little retard. That's what the poco means. Little retard there at the end. So so again, you know, the last few notes, you're gonna slow down. And then end the piece. So I think that pretty much covers it. You know, I could go into a lot more detail on things, but I think the things that I pointed out are the important things. And just to sum that up, articulations. Really pay attention to when you're supposed to tongue a note and when you're supposed to slur it. There are a lot of tricky spots in this where you might, if you're not thinking or paying attention, you might slur a note that is supposed to be tongued. And then the other thing that it's going to separate the students that do the absolute best, you know, end up at the top of the audition, you know, the top bands and everything. The ones who play dynamics, that's going to be very important, especially in this piece, because it kind of helps make the piece sound, you know, like a nice piece. You know, if you just play it all the way through and don't make any dynamic changes, it's just not as interesting. Okay, so that's it for the slow etude. I'll also make a video for the fast, or the technical etude, it's called. Okay, good luck.